In this tutorial, we're going to learn how to control the width of toon lines according to the distance to the camera in Flair for Maya, making them wider or thinner according to their depth. The same principles also apply to sketch lines, as lines share the same width attributes. I'm Henriette from Artineering, and we develop artist-driven tools for stylized rendering. Let's get started! In the previous tutorial, we learned how to control and art direct the intensity and width of lines. Now it is time to push things further
or closer
to have depth modify the line width. To control this, we need to select the Globals node on the Flair shelf by clicking on the globe icon. Once selected on the attribute editor, we find the line width range and line width factor attributes. They might look cryptic, but please allow me to explain them. The line width range attribute contains four values specifying depth ranges: close, close mid, and far distance from the camera. Directly underneath, we have the line width factors. The first factor is a line width multiplier at close range, whereas the second factor is a line width multiplier at far range. Here's a graphic to help visualize and simplify our explanation. We can place the camera here on the left, looking at the four depth range values from close to far. If you do not want the distance from the camera to affect the line width, you can simply set both line width factors to 1 and move on to the next tutorial. However, if you do want the full art direction experience, let's get our hands dirty. Let's say we normally have a line width of 2. Underneath the close and far range values, we can write the two factors, which for this example are going to be 3 and 0.2. So, the first range value is the closest to the camera, where the factor is fully active. In this case, with a normal line width of 2 and a line width factor of 3, the line width will be 6. The line width will then linearly go back to its normal value at the close mid distance, which is the second value in the line width range. Between the close mid distance and the far mid distance, the line width will remain at its normal value, which in this case is 2. Calculating the line width of the far range works the same way. We multiply the set line width of 2 by the second factor, 0.2, resulting in the line width of 0.4 for all lines in the far distance. And again, the line width will decrease linearly until it hits the far range value. If you understood this, it means we're on the same wavelength. So, give us a thumbs up and make sure to subscribe to our channel with a bell icon to be notified about future tutorials like this. Back to Maya. Now that we've understood how the attributes work, how do we apply it to our scene? First, to help us view the distance of objects from the camera, we can activate the object details under Display, Heads-up Display, Object Details. Within the object details, we can find the distance from camera information, which shows the distance from the camera of the selected object in Maya units. So, if I select this object, I can see this distance. And if I select another object, the distance will change accordingly. Before we continue, let's select the Globals node and copy the attribute editor interface by clicking on the Copy tab button. This will allow us to select objects and continue to see the global node attributes. We will also hide the attributes that are currently not of interest to us. Now, to set the correct line width range value, we might need to do some simple math with a world scale attribute. This scene has a world scale of 100, and this selected object, which we want to be in the mid-range, has this distance from the camera. So to put the correct distance into the range, we need to take the object's distance and divide it by the world scale. So this divided by 100 is the close mid-range value. You can set all the other depth range values according to the desired distances in your scene in the same way. If you want to go technical, you can also link this attribute to the specific objects using Maya Distance tool, Distance Between Node, or by writing an expression. But this is outside of the scope of this tutorial. Once you set up the remaining range values according to your scene, you can have lines that are wider the closer they get to the camera and thinner when they're further away. Or the other way around. It all depends on how you set the line width factors. Neat! We learned how to set up and fully control the line width along the depth. It is as simple as providing the distance from the camera at which the line width is increasing or decreasing, depending on the factors. For the next video, the time has come to add some color to these lines. Color can be based either on the object's original color, a custom global color, or its lighting color, or all of these combined. Thank you for watching this far, and if you love what we're doing, make sure to purchase a commercial license or become our patron to use Flair without resolution limitations and have your name appear in the credits of our video, like so. Color you on the next one.